Okay, same. So this is a body of mass U. Clear? Initial velocity is U. So it is striking with a ball of another similar mass, which is in rest position. Mass of this one is also M, mass of this one is also M. Okay, ma? And coefficient of restitution is given as E. Then we are supposed to find out this ratio, V2 by V1. Final velocity of second ball divided by final velocity of first ball. Clear? Come on. First of all, can we say it is an elastic collision or inelastic collision? Why? If coefficient of restitution, if it is equals to 1, then if it is an elastic collision also. So we cannot say whether it is an elastic collision or inelastic collision. Clear, ma? So because coefficient of restitution E is given, come on. So our final answer should be in terms of E only. Are you able to understand? So therefore, how can I solve? Let us see how we can do this question. So momentum is always conserved. So m1 u1 plus m2 u2 is equals to m1 v1 plus m2 v2. So m into u plus 0 is equals to m into v1 plus m into v2. So m into u is equals to m v1 plus m v2. So let it be my equation number 1. That's all, ma'am. By using law of conservation of momentum. Clear? Then he gave coefficient of restitution. Okay. Then what is coefficient of restitution? V2 minus V1 by U1 minus U2. So therefore, E into U1 minus U2 is equals to V2 minus V1. So first I will write equation for V2. So V2 is equals to V1 plus E into U1 minus U2. So let it be my equation number 2. That's all, no? So if I take this equation, substitute in equation number 1, then I will get equation for V1. That's all, no? Because we are trying to eliminate V2. Okay? So therefore, substituting 2 in 1, what can I write? So mu is equals to m into, instead of v1, what can I write? V1 only. Instead of v2, I can write v1 into v1 plus e into u1 minus u2. That's all, number. So from this, we try to get equation for v1. So mu is equals to mv1 plus m into V1 plus E into U1 minus E into U2. So therefore, MU is equals to MV1 plus MV1 plus M into E into U1 minus M into E into U2. Come on. So therefore, mass and mass gets cancelled. So U is equals to 2V1 plus E into U1 minus U2. Okay. From where I got U2? U2 is initial velocity of first body, no? So here, initial velocity of first body is 0. So I can substitute U2 is 0. So U is equals to 2V1 plus E into U minus 0. So therefore, 2V1 is equals to U minus E into U. So therefore, it is U into 1 minus E. So therefore, V1 is equals to U into 1 minus E divided by 2. So let it be my equation number 3. Are able to understand, ma? So I got equation for V1. Okay. Similarly, I can get equation for V2 also, no? So just to divide both of them. So that will be my required answer. Are you able to understand? So try to calculate V2. So I can substitute in this equation number directly. So u is equals to v1 plus v2. So u is equals to, instead of v1, what can I write? U into 1 minus e divided by 2 plus v2. So v2 is equals to u minus u by 2 into 1 minus e. So therefore v2 is equals to 2u minus u into 1 minus e divided by 2. So this is again equal to 2u minus u plus u into e divided by 2. Okay. So from here, what I will get? V2 is equals to u plus ue divided by 2. So u by 2, if I take common, then it is 1 plus e. So this is my equation number 4. What I want 4 by 3. That is v2 divided by v1. So u by 2 into 1 plus e divided by u by 2 into 1 minus e. So these two gets cancelled. So 1 plus e by 1 minus e. This is our answer for ratio of final velocities of these two bodies. That's all, Namma. So now let us see a general equation of impact. Impact means collision. Clear, ma? So previously we have derived two formulae, no, for final velocities. What are they? V1 is equals to m1 minus m2 by m1 plus m2 into u1 plus 2m2 divided by m1 plus m2 into u2. V2 is equals to m2 minus m1 by m1 plus m2 into u2 plus 2m1 divided by m1 plus m2 into u1. Clear? So these are the equations of final velocity for which condition? No. Only for elastic collision. That's all, Rama. But if inelastic collision is given and he asks you to find out the final velocity, then how can you do? By conservation of linear momentum, you will get two unknown quantities, no? In conservation of linear momentum, you will get final velocity of first body and final velocity of second body also. But I have only one equation. Two unknown variables are there. Then what can I do? No. See, equation is one equation. Two unknown quantities are there. How can you solve? We cannot solve. So what we try to do is, we will take the help of another equation. What can be another equation? Coefficient of restitution is there, no? That equation we can take help of. Okay, no ma? So therefore, for any type of collision, now we are trying to derive some equations of initial velocity or final velocities. Clear, ma? That is for whether it is an elastic collision, inelastic collision, perfectly inelastic collision, whatever may be the type. Clear? So in any condition, momentum is always conserved, no? So therefore I can write m1 u1 plus m2 u2 is equals to m1 v1 plus m2 v2. This condition is always satisfied. Clear? Next we have coefficient of restitution is v2 minus v1 by u1 minus u2. So therefore e into u1 minus u2 is equals to v2 minus v1. From this I can get equation for v2, no? V2 is equals to v1 plus e into u1 minus e2. That's all, no? So let it be my equation number 1, let it be my equation number 2. Now if I substitute 2 in 1, what I will get? If I take this equation, substitute here, what I will get? I will get v1 because v2 is eliminated, no? Similarly, I can get one more equation for v1 also. For v1, what is the equation I can write? V1 is equals to v2 minus e into u1 minus u2. Let it be my equation number 3. That's all, Namma. If I substituted this relation in this one, if I substitute this one, I will get V1. If I substitute this one, I will get V2. That's all, Amma. So this is how we can calculate final velocities for any type of collision. Clear? So if I substitute their values, if I solve these equations, then the velocities which I should get is V1 is equals to M1 minus EM2 divided by M1 plus M2 into U1 plus 1 plus E into M2 divided by M1 plus M2 into U2. This is the relation which I will get. Clear, ma? Now, for any kind of collision, whether it is elastic collision, inelastic collision, whatever may be the type of collision. Clear? And V2 what I will get? Then again, in previous condition, we have changed the subscripts, no? Instead of M1, if you are placing M2, then we are getting the final velocity of second body. Here also same condition. Clear? Just you change the subscripts. How can I change M2 minus EM1 divided by M1 plus M2 into U1 plus 1 plus E into M1 divided by M1 plus M2 into U2. So these are our two velocities. Final velocity of first body for any type of collision. Final velocity of second body for any type of collision. Are you able to understand? Now, by using these equations, previous problem we have done, no? Previous problem. What was the answer we got? V2 by V1 is equals to 1 plus E by 1 minus E we got, no? Check whether you get the same answer by using these relations or not. Clear? Come on, check it out. First make a note of this one. Where, ma? Here this is U2, this is U1. Okay. Come on, this is the given question. If a ball strikes with a velocity of U1 at a wall which itself is approaching with a velocity of U2. What is the meaning of this one? It means ball's velocity is U1 and wall is approaching the ball again with a velocity of U2. Then find the velocity of ball after collision with the wall. Final velocity of the ball we have to find out. No. Wall is also approaching. Already we have done this type of problem. So just to get a general equation, we are doing it again. Okay, come on. Problem in two methods. I am considering this collision to be elastic collision. Clear, ma? U1 plus? Correct. But in which direction? Which direction you are taking positive? But they are not moving upwards and downwards, sidewards they are moving. Okay. So we can do this problem in two methods, ma. First method, how can I solve? By using general equation of? Let us see. First method, by using general equation for final velocities. That's all, Amma. So V1 is equals to M1 minus M2 by M1 plus M2 into U1. And what is the second term? 2M2 divided by M1 plus M2 into U2. So here, if this type of questions are given, already we have discussed, Amma. Mass of the ball will be very small when compared to mass of the wall. So you can neglect the mass of the ball here. Are you able to understand? So for example, this is a ball, this is a wall. Clear? It is traveling in this direction, it is traveling in this direction. Its velocity is U1, its velocity is U2. I will consider mass of this one to be 0 and mass of this one to be M. Okay, because negligible masses, no? Just substitute now in the equation. So therefore V1 is equals to M1, 0, minus M divided by M into U1 plus 2 into M divided by M into, now U2, what about U2? This direction I am taking positive, then this direction will be negative, no? So minus U2, that's all, no? So V1 is equals to minus U1 minus 2 U2. So V1 is equals to minus of U1 plus 2 U2. So this is a very, very, very important result which we have to understand. Clear, ma? So what is this condition? So if one body is a very big body, okay, then what is the final velocity of the small body if it is striking and if it is returning back? Are you able to understand, ma? So directly from this equation, I can calculate the answer. So final velocity of a smaller body is how much? Minus of U1 plus 2U2. U1 is the velocity of ball. U2 is the velocity of bigger body, that is wall here. Are you able to understand? So this is one method of solving this problem. Any other method? Any other method can I solve? Coefficient of restitution is there, no? Understand? Elastic collision, one. That's all. So therefore, how can I solve by using second method? Let us see. So, just I will consider the coefficient of restitution. So, what is coefficient of restitution? E is equals to V2 minus V1 by U1 minus U2. That's all, Nama. Coefficient of restitution is 1 for elastic collision. So therefore, 1 is equals to, what is the final velocity? V2, what is V2 here? Final velocity of the wall, how much it will be?
Same,
because it is a very big body, no? Its initial velocity and final velocity will not change. So therefore, how can I substitute V2? But it is traveling in negative direction, no? So minus U2 I will write. That's all, no? And what is V1? V1? Final velocity of first ball, that we don't know. So let it be V1 only, divided by U1. Initial velocity of ball, which is how much V, na? Ball velocity is U1, and in positive direction. That's all, Nama. U2? Minus of minus U2. That's all, no? So therefore, U1 plus U2 is equals to minus U2 minus V1. So therefore, V1 is equals to, how can I write? Minus U2 minus U1 minus U2. So therefore, V1 is equals to minus of U1 plus 2U2. Again, we got the same answer, no? So in this method also, we can do the problem. Clear? Come on. So a ball falls from ceiling of a room and after rebounding twice from the floor, it reaches to a height equal to half the height of the ceiling. Clear, ma? Then find the coefficient of restitution. Very simple. Come on. This one, no? We have calculated a general equation for n number of rebounds. Already we have calculated, no? So h is equals to e power 2n into h. But you should be careful about what is this capital H and small h. What is capital H? Final height after nth rebound. Small h is? Initial height from which ball is falling. That's all, no? So h is equals to e power 2 into how many rebounds are there? 2 rebounds into h. H value is h itself. And after 2 rebounds, it is reaching to a height of half of the ceiling, no? So final height is h by 2. So h by 2 is equals to e power 4 into h. H gets cancelled. E power 4 is equals to 1 by 2. So e is equals to 1 by 4th root of 2. That is the coefficient of restitution. Okay, so these are 2 kg and 4 kg bodies, they are their initial velocities. Clear, ma? So after collision, velocity of 2 kg body is 2 meters per second in backwards direction. Understand? That is opposite to the direction of initial velocity. Then we are supposed to find out these values. What is the final velocity of 4 kg body? coefficient of restitution, impulse of deformation, potential energy at the time of maximum deformation, and impulse of reformation. Okay. What?
7/3.
Edi.
V force. First one.
Ah, okay. 4/3 na. So momentum is always conserved, no ma? So m1 u1 plus m2 u2 is equals to m1 v1 plus m2 v2. So initial mass of first body is 2, and its initial velocity is 4. Mass of second body is 4, its velocity is minus 2. So mass of first body is again 2, its velocity is minus 2, plus mass of second body is 4, its final velocity I don't know. So 8 minus 8, 0 is equals to minus 4 plus 4 into v2. V2 is equals to 1 meter per second. Mahat, are of your great people. Whatever you use, Sima, here you cannot use V1 and V2 formulae, because V1 and V2 formulae, they are equations for final velocities only in elastic collision. Understand? But this may be elastic collision, this may not be elastic collision, that we cannot say. But potential energy of deformation, impulse of reformation, they are inelastic. See, at the impulse of deformation and impulse of reformation, if they are given, it means definitely they are inelastic collisions. Understand? Okay, so this is our equation for final velocity of second body. Clear, ma? Then what he is asking? Coefficient of restitution. So E is equals to V2 minus V1 by U1 minus U2. Ah, correct. So final velocity is how much, ma? 1. Initial final velocity of first body, minus 2, na? Minus 2. Divided by initial velocity of first body, 4. Initial velocity of second body, minus 2. So total how much? 3 divided by 6 is equals to 0.5. So this is the coefficient of restitution. Are you able to understand? Then he is asking third question. So impulse of deformation. Clear? So actually what is meant by impulse? I is equals to F into T, no? Or in some of the books it is written as J also. J is equals to F into T. Clear, ma? So I is equals to F into T. Impulse is also called change in momentum also, no? Change in momentum. So mv minus mu, or you can write m into v minus u. So let us calculate for 2 kg body initially. Okay. Sima, what is meant by deformation?
Change in configuration.
Yes. Configuration you cannot say. Change in shape of the body. That's all, ma. When it is colliding, it was having an initial velocity of 4 meters per second at the instant of collision. Understand? So after completely, their velocities have become zero. Understand? At the point of collision, what will happen? Total velocities of both the bodies will become zero. That's what we studied in the initial classes, no? Law of conservation of kinetic energy is not satisfied at the instant of collision. When they are colliding, kinetic energy cannot be conserved. What is the reason? Because total kinetic energy of the bodies will be converted into potential energy. Understand? So their law of conservation of kinetic energy cannot be satisfied, because final velocities of both the bodies will become zero at the instant of collision. Clear, ma? So deformation means how I can write like this. For 2 kg body, mass of 2 kg body is 2 only. Final velocity is 0, no? After deformation has been successfully completed, final velocities will become 0. And what is its initial velocity? 4. So totally minus 8 newton into second. So this is the impulse of deformation of one body. Similarly, I can calculate for 4 kg body also, no? For 4 kg body, how much? Again same, m into v minus u. Mass is 4, final velocity is 0. Initial velocity of that body is how much? 2. And it is minus of minus 2, no? Why minus of minus 2? Because it is traveling in opposite direction. So total how much? 8 newton second. So what do you understand for 2 kg body and 4 kg body? Their impulses are equal. Magnitude wise they are equal, but directions are different. So this is the property of collision, no? In the first class we studied this one, do you remember? At the point of collision, impulse exerted by one body on the other body will be exactly equal to impulse exerted by the second body on the first body. But their directions will be different. Have you understood? Do you remember or not? We have written this equation, no? F12 is equals to minus F21. What is the meaning of this? Force exerted by first body on second body must be equal to force exerted by second body on first body, but in opposite direction. If you multiply these terms by T, delta T, then what you will get? Impulse. F into T, impulse only, no? That's what we have done the calculations previously. So impulses are equal at the time of collision, but they will be in opposite direction. That's the exactly result which we got here. That's all, Amma? Okay. So make a note up to here and try to calculate these two values also. Fourth question and fifth question. So, can you say how can I calculate this potential energy of deformation? Any idea? M where?
4 kg block with the final velocity depending on the mass minus 2
kg. What is meant by potential energy of deformation? By reading this statement, what do you understand? Kinetic energy? That's all. So at the time of collision, total kinetic energy of balls it has converted into potential energy. So by law of conservation of energy, if one energy vanishes, another energy should appear, no? That's all, Amma. So total initial kinetic energy is nothing but potential energy of deformation, that's all. Understand? So therefore, what can I write? Potential energy maximum is equals to half m1 u1 square plus half m2 u2 square, that's all. Initial kinetic energy of first body, initial kinetic energy of second body. At the time of deformation, both these energies, they will vanish, no? And they are converted into deformation energy of the bodies. Deformation energy is nothing but energy stored in the body by change in shape also, no? Which is called as potential energy. That's all, Amma. So just do this calculation, that should be our answer. Mass is how much? 2. Velocity is 4 square. Half into mass is 4, velocity is 2 square. So 16 plus 2 into 4, 8. 24 joules. That should be our answer. That's all, no? That's all. Next, try to calculate kinetic energy of reformation. Sorry, impulse of reformation. So what is meant by impulse of reformation? So after completely deforming, then they start moving again, no? So that is again potential energy starts converting into kinetic energy. That process we call it as reformation. Understand, Amma? So again I can calculate for both the bodies, 4 kg body and 2 kg body. For 2 kg body, so impulse of reformation is equals to, how can I write, m into v minus u. That's all, Amma? Mass of 2 kg body is 2. Final velocity of 2 kg body is how much? 2, no? So minus 2. It will traveling in opposite direction, minus 2. And at the point of deformation, what was its velocity? 0. 0, no? So 0. So minus 4 newton into second. That's all, Amma? Similarly, for 4 kg body, impulse of reformation is equals to 4 into, what is its final velocity? 1, plus 1. And initial velocity is 0. So 4 Newton into second. So again, you can observe here. So the one is minus 4 and another one is plus 4. But what was the impulse of deformation? Plus 8 and minus 8. So why impulse have decreased here? At the time of collision, at the time of deformation, impulse exerted by one body and the other body was 8 Newton second. But when they were separating, impulse have reduced. Why? So is Newton's law not satisfied here? Newton's law is definitely satisfied. One is 4, another is minus 4. Then what happened to remaining impulse? It reduced because some of the kinetic energy is reduced, no? Some of the kinetic energy has reduced. This is an inelastic collision. So that is why the final impulse of reformation has reduced. That's all. Are you able to understand? Okay, simple. So here, three blocks are given. So B and C, they are connected by a spring and they are resting on frictionless surface. We are not considering friction here. Clear, ma? So 1 kg, 2 kg and they are at rest position. So a body of mass 1 kg, it is coming and striking this block B with a speed of 3 meters per second and we are considering this collision to be elastic collision. Okay? Then natural length. Natural means initial distance between these two blocks is 80 centimeter. Then what will be the minimum separation between B and C after the collision? That is the question. Clear, ma? So when this collides elastically with this body, then what is the final distance between 1 and 2? That's all he is asking. In minimum separation between blocks B and C is how much? Okay? Think. Sima, here, if this 3 kg body, if it comes and collides with B, understand? Ma? So initially, which body will move? Will B move or will C move? Definitely B will move because there was no restoring force between B and C, no? Restoring force is zero because spring was in relaxed position. And already we have studied when spring is compressed, restoring force starts acting in opposite direction, no? F is equals to kx in one direction and kx in another direction. Kx is elongation. Initially there was no elongation or compression, no? So only block B will start movement. After collision, can you say anything about speed of block A?
V by 3, sir.
After collision, what will be the velocity of block A? That is my question. Collision is elastic. This is the point which you should understand. What is meant by elastic collision? That is inelastic collision. No? See carefully. If you observe the data carefully, you can understand what is happening here.
Sir, same.
Which one will stop?
A.
A will stop after collision. That's all, no? So this is the result which we have studied previously, no? If masses of both the bodies are same, mass of this body is 1, mass of this body is also 1, and initially we are not considering this system because there was no restoring force, no? So immediately after collision, this body will stop because masses are equal. And this body will travel with the initial velocity of first body. That is the condition of elastic collision, no? When masses are equal. Are you able to remember? If 1 kg body strikes with another 1 kg body in rest position, first body will stop. Second body will take the velocity of first body and it will start movement. Understand, ma? But the problem is, now can I say total velocity of the body is 3? total velocity of this system is, can I say it is equal to 3 meters per second? No, only initially its speed was 3 immediately after collision. Okay, so when it starts movement with 3, this spring will compress no more. If this spring compresses, then it starts giving restoring force on both the bodies. So because of this restoring force, this body also starts movement. Then again the velocities of the bodies will change. How they will change? Velocity of this body continuously decreases. Velocity of this body continuously increases. So this happens up to which position? Velocity of this body decreases up to which position? And velocity of this one increases up to which velocity? Until both of them get the same velocity. That's all, Rama. Initially its velocity was 3. So its velocity continuously decreases and its velocity continuously increases because of restoring force. Are you able to understand? And when the both the bodies, when they attain equal velocity, then the change of velocities will stop. Okay? So instead of studying all this nonsense, we can study very simply by center of mass, no? We can study by the concept of center of mass. So here, spring forces are internal forces, no? Spring forces are internal forces, and center of mass cannot change, velocity of center of mass cannot change because of internal forces. This is what we studied. Now you consider both of them to be one body of 1 plus 2, 3 kg. Now I can do the calculation. No? So m1 u1 plus m2 u2 is equals to m1 plus m2 into final velocity. Why I am taking final velocity? Both of them I am considering to be a single body. And here V represents velocity of center of mass. That's all. Okay. Now, what is the initial velocity of first body? 1. Its initial velocity is 3. So, 0. Plus masses are how much? 1 plus 2. Final velocity is V center of mass. So, V center of mass is equals to 3 by 3 is equals to 1 meter per second. This is our reasoning. Understand, ma? Why we are considering them to be a single body? We are considering the position of center of mass. And internal forces cannot change the velocity or position of center of mass. That's all, Rama. So I got answer up to here. So, but still my answer is not completed. No, what he is asking, minimum separation between B and C. So how can I calculate this one? Now again I can consider law of conservation of energy, no? Law of conservation of mechanical energy I can use. Law of conservation of total energy I can use. Work energy theorem I can use. Any theorem I can use here, because all these forces are conservative forces. Spring forces are conservative forces, no? So therefore here what can I write? Total initial kinetic energy is equals to final kinetic energy plus energy stored in the spring. Can I write like this? Which body was having initially kinetic energy? Only mass A. And what is its kinetic energy? Half into, mass is 1, velocity is 3 square is 9. Final kinetic energy means both these bodies, they have started moving with a velocity of 1. So therefore, half into, masses are 1 plus 3, 3, 1 plus 2, 3, velocity is 1 square. Plus energy stored in a spring. We know the formula, no? Half into K into X square. K value is not given, huh? K value is 150 newtons per meter. So half into K value is 150 into X value, X square. So from this I can calculate X value, no? What is meant by X here? Compression in the spring, not extension. No, just if I calculate X value, I will get what is the compression. But this is not my answer. What is my answer? Length between, distance between these two bodies, no? Initial distance was how much? 80. Now length has decreased by X value. So therefore, final distance between them is how much? Final distance between B and C is how much? 80 minus x. So that should be our answer. X is a total compression in the spring. Okay, come on. Seema, see this question. So this is a body of mass m, body of mass 2m. Clear? We are naming them as A and B. So what is the velocity of this body? That is not given. But he gave in terms of kinetic energy and momentum. This is having a kinetic energy of K. It is having a momentum of P. And the second body's kinetic energy and momentum will be zero, no? Because it is in rest position. Clear, Nama? And this is an elastic collision. So after the collision, we want to find out the final kinetic energy ratios. Kinetic energy of body A divided by kinetic energy of body B after collision. Huh? No.
1 is to
1, sir. 1 is to 1, no. Masses vary, kada. Masses energy can never be negative. Because what is the equation of kinetic energy? Kinetic energy half mv square, no? Can mass be negative? And velocity, if it is negative or positive, we are squaring this one, no? So kinetic energy is always positive. And also we studied that kinetic energy depends on the frame of reference also. But still always it is positive. Because velocity is always positive. Okay? Come on. So, how can I do this problem? To calculate final kinetic energies, I require final velocities, no? But initial velocity is also not given. How can I calculate? Huh? Kinetic energy of block A divided by kinetic energy of block. No, final kinetic energies. Okay, Seema. So, first of all, I have a relation between kinetic energy and momentum, no? What is the relation? K is equals to P square by 2m. This relation I have. Already we studied this relation in the previous classes, no? No. So K is equals to P square by 2m. This is the relation which we have. But this relation is not useful here. Because there is no idea on velocity in this condition. I have one more equation for kinetic energy and momentum relation, no? K is equals to half PV. This relation also I have, no? We studied two relations for kinetic energy and momentum. This is one of the relation. K is equals to half PV. From this one, I can calculate velocity, no? Here V means velocity only. So V is equals to 2K divided by P. So this is my initial velocity of first body. That's all, no? So initial velocity of first body is 2k divided by p. Now I can do the calculation. So what is v1? m1 minus m2 divided by, correct. m1 plus m2 into u1 plus 2m2 divided by m1 plus m2 into u2. In your final initial velocity of second body is 0, no? So total this term will become 0. So therefore v1 is equals to masses are m minus mass second body is 2m divided by 3m into initial velocity of first body 2k divided by p. That's all, Nama. So v1 is equals to minus 1 by 3 into 2k divided by p. So this is my initial velocity of first body. That's all. So if I have final velocity of first body, if I know final velocity, I can calculate its kinetic energy, no? So what is the final kinetic energy of first body? Half mv square. Half into mass of this body is m. Velocity is how much? 1 by 3 into 2k divided by p whole square. So this is the kinetic energy of block A, body A. Okay? Similarly, calculate final velocity of second body. V2 is equals to m2 minus m1 divided by m1 plus m2 into u2 plus 2m1 divided by m1 plus m2 into u1. That's all, Amma. Again, initial velocity of second body is 0, no? So this total term will become 0. So v2 is equals to 2 into m divided by 3m into initial velocity of first body, 2k divided by p. That's all, Amma. So MM gets cancelled. V2 is equals to 2 by 3, or I can write 4 by 3 into K divided by P. So from this again I can calculate final velocity, final kinetic energy of block B, no? So half into mass of this body is how much? 2m. And velocity is how much? 4 by 3 into K by P whole square. That's all, no? So what I want? I want this relation Ka divided by KB. Okay? So do this calculation. The answer which I should get is 1:8. That is our answer.